going on, guys? Welcome back to American Truck Simulator. My name is Moose78. Hopefully you guys are doing well today, by the way. And this is my ATS Let's Play series, Stories from the Road. Kind of back with the traditional Stories from the Road format here. Just kind of me just driving and chatting up and whatnot. But don't worry, we're still going to be doing the live stream thing as well. Been having a lot of fun with that, enjoying that. A lot of people coming out and interacting in the chat, so that's pretty awesome. So thank you guys for that, and I do appreciate your support. But we are here in San Francisco, California today. Got a dry bulk of sugar. We're taking over to Camp Verde, Arizona. Take a look at the manifest there real quick. Just over 40,000 pounds. We are in the Kenworth W900A model. This is the model that was originally done by Bayonet, a.k.a. Chris, back in the day, back in the Holland days. This was converted over by a couple people, but this particular version is one that X-Driver is working on. And this thing is awesome. I wish I would have used this truck back in Holland. I never really used it a lot, but I've definitely been using it quite a bit here the last week or so here in ATS, of course. And this thing is amazing. Nice, clean, good-looking truck. So keep up the good work on it, X-Driver. Can't wait to see what you have in store for it next. But we'll hop in here on the interior. And the trailer, I can't remember exactly where I got the trailer, so there is no link for the trailer or the truck as well. But take a look on the inside, and you can just see this thing is pretty daggone well detailed. Now, one cool thing is when you start it up... I guess it didn't go through the animation there. There we go. Kind of see how the shifter moves, the window goes up, the fan kind of does its thing. There we go. Fired up. Go out here and get the truck in. Kind of get you guys up to speed on what's going on and all that good stuff. Been pretty busy here the last few weeks, just haven't had a whole lot of time to sit down and really make any content. Been working a little bit, actually quite a bit, on getting the Twitch page, my Twitch channel, up and running. A link for that, of course, is down in the video description. And I know initially I said I probably wasn't going to stream over to Twitch a whole bunch, but that's, now that I've done it over there a couple times, that's probably primarily where I'm going to stream. I'll try to do some streams over here on YouTube every once in a while, but it's just so much easier to get a stream up and running over there as opposed to YouTube here. The UI just kind of sucks for live streaming here on YouTube, honestly. You know, I tried to schedule a couple of events and just for whatever reason, it's not pushing notifications out. It is a much, much better interface over on Twitch, much easier to set up. I mean, I literally click a couple buttons and boom, you know, going live. It's a lot easier to interact with the chat. Kind of check everything out, make sure everything's running good. Around this curve here. Kind of messing around with my brake sensitivity again, trying to get it dialed in just a little bit more. Try to keep it realistic, but also, you know, kind of functional as well, too. But I've been working, you know, quite a bit trying to get the stream dialed in, and, you know, get the settings looking really good. That way you guys have a good viewing experience, that good balance between quality and performance. Also was playing quite a bit of the Ghost Recon's Wildlands beta there a couple weekends ago. That game's actually, well, by the time this video goes live, it'll be out. But so I want to get into that, play that some, probably stream some of that over on Twitch as well. You know, Twitch, I'm, you know, primarily going to stream ATS over there. That's going to be, you know, where I stream, you know, when I'm playing The Division, I might stream some of that, you know, Wildlands, I'll stream some of that over there. But, you know, over here on YouTube, it's primarily, you know, 99% going to be just, you know, well, I should say, well, yeah, probably about 99% just ATS. I still want to get LSPDFR back up and running. I've been saying that since, like, the beginning of time, but hopefully I get enough content kind of in the queue here to where I have some time to sit down and get that completely reinstalled. Just with the way everything's been here the last, you know, few weeks, kind of want to primarily focus on ATS, get back in my routine with this, and, you know, get this back up and running. Continue to see growth, so I'm pretty pleased with that. You know, closing in on 1,000 subs, and it's going to be pretty damn awesome once we hit that. To do some live stream, you know, maybe 2-3 days a week. On my last live stream, I was talking about trying to come up with, you know, kind of a tentative schedule, you know, kind of kicking some stuff around. You know, thought about doing like a Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, you know, like 10 to 1 each day, doing ATS. And maybe, you know, if I'm going to stream something different, I'll let you guys know. So that way, if you're here for the ATS content, you know, and you don't want to watch necessarily the other stuff, you know, way you got a little bit of heads up. That way you're not expecting ATS content and you're seeing something else and you're like, what the deuce? You go get in your truck and you go get in your truck now. And I know I said a couple weeks back there, my schedule may or may not change for the, right now it's not gonna change, so still going to be able to work on this stuff during the daytime, then of course working there as well. And like I said before, this is, you know, this isn't a full-time gig, this is just a hobby. You know, like I've always said, as long as I continue to see growth and everything on the channel, I'll still, you know, put a little bit of time into it, try to grow it a little bit, and who knows where it ends up one of these days. Gotta sit back and see, I guess. But I still wanted to, you know, upload just, I guess, you know, kind of the traditional stories on the road a couple times a week as well. But honestly, you know, what I'm doing on the live stream is absolutely no different than what I've been doing in Stories on the Road, just with the exception of it's, you know, live interaction instead of interacting down in the comment section, which it's pretty cool, I gotta say. You know, having people come out and hang out for a couple hours and, you know, we just talk trucking, talk cars, you know, whatever. You know, some people have been asking me here and there how I got into trucking and stuff like that, so that's a good time. If you got the time, you know, definitely stop by for a little bit. Say hi, come hang out with the chat. Already starting to see some regular faces and whatnot, which is pretty cool. Always a fun hill to pull coming out of San Fran. I have I think it's the 3406E 550 horsepower engine in this with an 18 speed, of course. Gotta stick with that 18 speed. The reason why I always use the 18 speeds is, one, I like it, but two, that's how I have everything set up for my SKRS. You know, the shift pattern, all that stuff. That way, you know, if I do change to like a 13 speed or whatever, I don't have to go back in and change my shift pattern. You know, just stick with an 18 speed and kind of set it and forget it, if you will. Thank you. I think there's a lot of cool stuff coming up on the channel. Gonna continue to, like I said, gonna continue to try to do some live stream, and I'll continue to get some of that footage up and share that with you guys as well. But also gotta, you know, I want to get the Mac Pinnacle mod review done this week as well. That'll probably go up later in the week, because I kind of want to try to change my format on, you know, how I do my mod reviews and everything, for at least on trucks. I absolutely hate this coming through here. It just, I don't know, just seems like a big freaking free-for-all. You know, luckily there's not a lot of traffic out, so we got that going for us. And I am on the 1.6 open beta. It was kind of funny, I was streaming on Wednesday when the beta went live, and I think it came out. Don't want my lights on yet. I think it came out literally probably maybe half an hour after I started streaming. I think it was Bear hopped in stream and was asking if I'd okay, that was a little bit closer than I cared for. Asked me if I'd got onto the beta yet. I'm like, what? Beta's live? Shenanigans. Almost hopped out of game. Whoa. Hey there, buddy. Turn. See, that's what I hate. What's he waiting on? I am in no way interfering with his, you know, lane of traffic. Anywho, I almost updated right there on stream, but I kind of figured, there'll probably be some mod conflicts and all that jazz, so I really don't want to monkey around with that on a live stream. So later that evening, I got everything all set up for the open beta, and really didn't have to take a whole lot of stuff out. I took all my map mods out because MHA was conflicting, so I went ahead and took out Viva Mexico too. Hey there, Smokey Bear. How you doing? Oh boy, he's gonna follow us. Super duper. Super duper. But I got a good chance to drive way down south in Mexico there. That was a lot of fun. Took forever and a day, but it was good times, good drive. Got to check out some new map and whatnot. And then, of course, just been checking out the open beta. I seen before I loaded up the game today that it updated again, so I'll have to go back and check the SES forums. Well, if you go to, if you guys don't know, if you go to the SES forums and go under announcements, they have a little section there where they just have like some brief patch notes as to what they changed and updated. Not extremely detailed, but at least gives you kind of a general idea of what's been updated. So far, you know, I'm really liking the open beta. I mean, you know, like we were talking there on stream the other day, not a huge update in terms of content, but I think there's a lot of little things mixed in there that are going a long way in improving the game. You know, the new sounds and stuff like that are very nice. The different transmission modes. I want to get, say, this week when I stream one of the days, I'll probably use the stock 579 just to kind of check out some of the different transmission modes. See how all that works out. But we have diff locks now, which is kind of interesting. You know, we're all trying to figure out how that's going to be utilized in-game. And of course, the big one that came out of it was the liftable trailer axles, which I know has got a lot of people in the mining community pretty excited, because now they can get some serious heavy haul stuff in game. And I can just kind of slow down just a little bit here. Okay. Kind of yapping away there, not paying attention to where I was going. it seems like there's a lot of stuff available now for the modders. They've updated the blender tools. That pretty much got updated right away, which I thought was really good. I'm actually going to try to give Blender a shot. I was having a conversation with Smarty there the other day on Facebook about it.
Yeah.
Because, you know, I'm not really familiar. I've never used Blender at all. I've, you know, opened it up, looked at it a couple times, but never really done anything in it. Just nothing at all. So, you know, I asked a couple people, you know, what's the benefits or what are some, highlights to Blender versus Zmodeler? And kind of one of the things that really, got me interested in wanting to learn Blender was it, with the SES tools, it just better optimizes the model versus, you know, what Zmod does. So that's one of the big reasons why I really want to use them. You know, a better optimized model means, you know, better FPS. So I'm all about getting all the FPSs that I can. And plus, if I ever release stuff, you know, you guys are getting some good quality stuff, and it's not going to absolutely tank your performance. And that's kind of another thing, you know, as I, you know, try to get some content built up in the queue and stuff like that and get kind of ahead of schedule, I also want to, you know, be able to do that so I can sit down and do some modding as well. You know, I haven't touched Zmodeler in forever. I literally threw in a pair of Kenworth wheels from Holland. I was going to start working on converting that, and that's about as far as it got. Literally got the wheels in Zmod, and that was it. So, luckily I'm not too far along in, the exception of the T680. I got to figure out what I want to do with that, and how I want to go about doing that. If I just kind of want to start that project kind of from scratch, and do it in Blender, kind of start small and kind of work my way up. I don't know, but I definitely want to get back into mod and stuff like that, because it seems like it's the modding community is getting really active, which is really awesome. Seeing a lot of cool stuff here lately. You know, this W9 A model, of course, the Mac Pinnacle, the East Genesis end dump that I use there on stream. There's going to be some content of that going up on the channel later this week as well. And of course, I did a mod preview on it, I should say. Not really a mod review, but more of a preview. And I've seen some other stuff kind of here and there as well. So, I think year two is going to be a pretty good year for ATS, just with everything that SES is doing. You know, it seems like the modding community is, you know, kind of growing. Getting a little bit more active. I think we're got the potential, but easier for me to say. I think we have the potential to have a really good year two for this game. I do. Too much longer, we're getting open beta in New Mexico. What the heck was that? I think that was my track IR. Kind of hiccup there. You know, that was kind of another topic on one of the streams, was DLC and what states kind of we want to go next to and all that stuff. And of course, I was all about that Pacific Northwest. And it seemed like that was kind of the general consensus with the chat on stream, too. You know, it's nice having, the desert states and all that stuff, but seems like everyone's kind of excited for the PNW as well. And I thought I read somewhere on chat that someone said they got a team working going east and they got a team working on heading up north. Which, if that's the case, that would be pretty awesome. So that way, you know, hopefully we can get some updates a little bit quicker. Which, that would kind of make sense. Because I think they've really done a good job of kind of setting the standard with the rescale and some of the other stuff they've done since the rescale. You know, with the 1.6 open beta here. standards definitely set moving forward. Good sounding engine mod for sure. I just love how clean this thing is, though. You know, not a bunch of unnecessary junk, you know, added to it. Kept it pretty true to the original, which is awesome. You know, same thing with the outside of the truck. It's nice and clean. Just perfect. Just absolutely perfect. Now, sooner or later, I'll probably kind of maybe add some of my own touches to it, kind of here and there. You know, of course, you know, if you guys know me, you know, I'll throw a two-piece light bar on there because, you know, that's how I roll. But that's something I've always added to my trucks way back into the hauling days even. You guys remember the 387 I had, or that wasn't mine, it's the one that was done by EVH up 5150 there back in the day. I even had a two-piece light bar on that, so. And of course I got a two-piece light bar, tack on it. I don't know why the game does that, but I even have a two-piece light bar on my 680. I just, you know, you doing, game? Just on a hunch, I turned hyper-threading off on my CPU to see if that would have any effect at all on the performance, and it hasn't, so I'll get that set back to what it was before. But I thought maybe that might help for whatever reason, with this, you know, lags or the spikes like that, lag spikes or whatever you want to call them. I don't even have anything overclocked right now, and I'm still getting them kind of here and there. Not as bad as I was on stream the other day, but that was nuts. Still need to go back and mess around a little bit with my NVIDIA Inspector profile. Because it seems like since they made it some updates to the realistic weather mod that I use from the Steam Workshop, seems like it gets a little bit darker than it was there for a while. Because when I first started using that mod, it was looking great. Wasn't having the darkness issues. Might go back and kind of fiddle around with my inspector profiles just a bit. See if I can't get it dialed in just a little bit better. Chicken see where we're at here on ZMAP. Caught up on Bakersfield, making pretty good time. Still got a pretty good clip to go, so we'll probably break this up into a couple episodes. And that's okie dokie. but I feel like I got a pretty good, pretty good stable of trucks, for the lack of a better term, that I'm using right now to kind of keep everything mixed up and kind of fresh on the channel. And I got the 680, got this now, got the SES W900, Pinnacle. Want to break the 579 back out. Probably won't hurt to use the old 389 every once in a while too. There for a second. He's turning, that's good. Good how the sun's shining in there on the dash. Pretty cool shot. I'd love to own one of these things in real life. That would be freaking awesome. Whoops. Did not want to open up the menu. Close for another rest here. So I actually do open up ZMAP. There are plenty of places to stop here. In old B-Town. We'll mark that spot. Because reasons. Like how they add little stuff like that in game to make the environment a little bit more alive. Thought he was turning there for a second. I guess not. Clear that, but I still didn't rub it just a little bit. Silly old moose. Silly old moose. Until it should just be over here on our left. Thank you. I see the light a little bit better. So it's kind of hard seated through the fan there. Was there like a signal back there that I didn't see? Oh, okay, I'll be damned. I did not notice that. I was looking at the light over there on the pole, the lower one there. Didn't even see the signal up there. Well, shame on me. Alright guys, that is going to wrap it up for another episode of Stories from the Road. Hopefully you guys enjoyed it. If so, just give the video a like and a share. This helps me out a bunch and helps the channel grow. And if you're new to the channel and are not already subscribed, please take a look around, watch a couple videos, and consider subscribing now. But guys, I'm going to cut on over here for now. Be sure to keep an eye out over there on the Twitters for any updates on streams or anything like that. And be sure to follow me over there on Twitter. Follow me on Twitter, but also follow me over there on Twitch as well for the live streams. Links for both are down in the video description. But guys, until the next time, stay safe out there. Take care, and we'll be seeing ya.